Yeehaw! We can do it in a Texas way, we can do it in an English way and just say, hello. But either way, greetings, you are most welcome. This fine game here is Doctor Who Legacy. Get it? Legacy. No, Legacy. It's wordplay. It's wordplay. We're going to have fun here for the next hour because you've got an hour of me. And we've got Susan. And we've got... Oh, there's something on my finger. And we've got gameplay. We've got things to unlock. We've got characters to play with. We've got enemies to destroy. We've got giveaways galore. And we get to use him. You know? Him. Tom is here. I do hope you guys have been having fun using Tom throughout this past week, which was very, 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 very cool. And I guess because we're going to be putting Tom into a team, that means that this week he's going to have a team. And, you know, if we're making a new team, then, you know, we need to call it Week of the Team, or better known as Team of the Week, people.
You gotta try the Team of the Week. Team of the Week. If you're out of luck and your strategy sucks and there's something new you seek, try the Team of the Week. Yeah, the Team of the Week. Try the Team of the Week, people. It'll make you feel good inside.
Well, I'm feeling good inside right now. And I guess technically we should actually call this the Tom of the Week. Tom of the Week. Granted, I nicked that from ZRS1 in the chat, but I sold it as if it was my own. And that's the main thing. Here it is, this week's Team of the Week. And of course, being a Tom Baker team, we needed to go for the team which has Tom Baker-related characters in it. So we've got... Tom Baker, the fourth Doctor, complete with fluffy hair, scarf, and starry eyes. We've got young Sarah Jane, not old Sarah Jane. No, thank you. That was a David Tennant companion. Young Sarah Jane. Thank you very much. We've got K9, Tom's faithful companion. We've got the TARDIS, the Doctor's faithful ship. We've got the Brigadier, the Doctor's faithful army friend, and Clara. I had an issue with the sixth character. I'll be honest. I had an issue with the last two, actually. I was like, well, Tom and Sarah Jane. And I was like, who else did you travel with? K9, there we go. What other characters have I got that go with him? Well, it is the TARDIS. We can always stick the TARDIS in because all the Doctors have the TARDIS. A little bit cheaty, but it works. And then I was like, who else have I got? Who else have we got that's around at the time? Because what Doctor Who Legacy has got loads of is all the modern stuff. And what they're spilling in very slowly, but it is coming very slowly, is the classic stuff. And I'm sure if we were having this conversation in 6 months, we'll be like, well, I could put this one, I could put that one, yada, 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 yada. But I was a bit like, oh my God, who can I put? Then I was like, we could put the Brigadier in, because he's obviously a classic character from way back in the day. He's been with almost all the Doctors, I think. And then I thought, well, who on earth would be there at the time? I thought about Bessie, and I thought, no, Bessie was the third Doctor. I thought about the Whomobile, and I thought, no, the Whomobile was the third Doctor as well. He gets all the cars. And I was like, well, who else has actually been with the fourth Doctor at any point that is currently in Doctor Who Legacy? The other one I debated was Strax, because the fourth Doctor has fought the Centaurans and things like that. So then I was like, Clara, because technically Clara is the girl that saves the Doctor, all of the Doctors. And do you remember that clip where, like, she goes back and she saves various Doctors at various points? So she's been everywhere in the Doctor Who's timeline, so therefore she is a companion of the fourth Doctor too. Did I get away with it? Did I get away with it? Although some of you are saying that Tom drove Bessie. I didn't know that. Really? Tom was with Bessie? Let me Google this. Let me Google this. You lies. Tom Baker, Bessie. Google says. Ah. Hang on, that's all the Doctors and Bessie. Wow, that's a serious tan going on there. Is that the Fourth Doctor and Bessie? Maybe it is. Huh. Maybe I could have used Bessie. Either way, I'm still seeing if I can sell Clara. Cool. Anyway, so my team of the week involves Clara. Now, of course, before you use a team, what do you need to do? You need to set up your perks. Now, this team, as you can see, is a bit of a higgledy-piggledy of colours. We've got a little bit of everything. A little bit of red, a little bit of blue, a little bit of green. The main two colours that are there, or the only colours that are there three times, are yellow and blue. If you look at all the dual colours there, we've got yellow and blue. So we'll set up our perks to go with those two, although we will get quite a lot out of both of it. So don't forget, never forget to change your perks over, because otherwise you'll be causing yourself problems. So we'll leave the blue one on, but then with the second one that increases damage, we'll increase yellow instead, which also works quite nicely for split damage. And then I think most of the rest will be fine. I can just kind of leave in place. Increase blue damage. Yeah, we can leave the blue one there. But let's change that to match yellow gems. And that'll work nicely there. And then I think all the S perks will be fine. We'll be fine, we'll be fine, we'll be fine, we'll be fine. Good. So I'm going to get blasting things. Let us bring in our beloved co-host. This is Susan from Tiny Rebel Games. She is the architect, the producer, the brains behind the brawn, the beauty behind the beast. This is Susan.
Why, hello.
Wow, wow, that's a shouty Susan. I'm going to turn down the volume.
Why, hello.
Wow. Ah, son of a... Now it's a whispering demon, Susan. How are you?
Why, hello. Why, hello.
I like that. That's better. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you. Welcome.
Oh, hang on.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. How are you today?
I'm playing with Tom.
Tom? Wait.
Tom.
Wait. Tom Baker's in the game?
Well, I know he technically was the one that you wanted to miss out the game, but I found him in a secret...
We forgot about Tom Baker. You know, for the longest time, we totally forgot there was a Fourth Doctor.
You did?
You did.
You did, but here he is. We've got him in.
And then some folks on support and Facebook and Twitter were kind enough to remind us that...
They were, and emailed you repeatedly.
Yes, indeed. And we're like, yeah, you're right. There's a Fourth Doctor, and we need to get him in. So we did.
So how did you release Tom? Because obviously I know, but you know, do kind of share, because there was various promos on a few different websites, wasn't there?
It was just one. Well, it got picked up by loads. You know, Kotaku, the gaming site, which gave us a really lovely write up a few months ago. Mike Fahey over there is a big fan of the game, and so we asked him if he wanted to do it, because you know we get a lot of great coverage with the Doctor Who sites, but you know, with the gaming sites in the U.S., we've had a sort of harder time making them aware of the game, and so it's really fun that some of the gaming sites are starting to really pick up on it as well. And so Kotaku covered it, and so did Game Informer, which is really exciting. So that was fun, and yes, yeah, so
Game Informer, that's a big site.
Yeah, Game Informer covered it too, which was great. So Kotaku put a code out that was good through the end of the weekend, and so that's expired now. If you didn't get it, he's only two time crystals in the store. We made it very, very easy to get Tom Baker, and this weekend we're adding him to the big ultimate mega doctor pack. It is now, and that includes all the doctors, and that'll be coming this
all
weekend.
The doctors that have ever been and ever shall
exactly.
be.
Exactly.
Oh, hang on, I get to do some dialogue. Annoyingly, this is fine, I'm not annoyed. This first level is going to stop me being Tom and force me to be the Third Doctor. That's fine, that just builds up the anticipation for playing as Tom later in the stream. But here we go, this is John.
As the TARDIS emergency maintenance systems repaired itself, I closed my eyes and fell into a restless slumber. The dreams of a Time Lord are not always the most peaceful. I'm never alone in my dreams. And they came against the infinity of the vortex. They swiped at me. Grabbed at me. The horrors of a time traveler's past haunt his dreams for eternity. Those horrors are just a set of space-time coordinates away. It's deep stuff. Thank you, Lee, for sharing your deepness.
I'm so glad he's out getting our son, because he'd be horrified by that.
I like his dialogue.
He hates
it's
hearing
cool.
his dialogue read. He gets all upset when I read it to him.
Oh, cool! And you've got these guys from Lord of the Rings in here. That's cool. I always thought these guys, troll-like creatures, didn't get enough.
The Ogron, yeah.
So how the hell are you? And how has your week been?
It's been a really good week. You know, we have this, you know, the season 8 thing, and that's been really, really different and unique. And I don't think anyone has ever been mad enough to try what we've done. And the first third of the season was pretty straightforward because we had the stuff and plenty of time. And then we started playing catch up to the point that, like, now for this week's content, it was basically drawn like a day or two ago. And so then between Taiwan time zones and British time zones, it gets a bit crazy. But we're approved. We're done. Everything is ready for the weekend. I have no stress right now on my shoulders going into Halloween of whether content can come out. Addie's got the art to show off today because
I do. Although I debated this one with Lee earlier. Did he tell you about our debate?
No, because we have a big announcement of who's coming this weekend. We haven't said yet, have we? I think it's an announcement.
Well, no, we haven't. But then my point with him was like, well, isn't that a spoil? Because he hasn't told me who it is. I haven't opened the email yet.
Oh,
but I was
no,
like, well, isn't that actually a spoiler?
It's out there. People know. It's in the trailer and stuff. I'm sure people could guess by now, people in the channel, right? Who's coming this weekend? Who's our new ally? Anybody watching tag?
I don't know because we've already got the doctor and we've already got Clara.
I know. Who gets a cookie for guessing?
But surely it will be a new character. Surely it's a spoiler. You're spoiling me. You'll lose all your viewers. Everyone will be like, I'm not, and they'll quit.
Do you guys want to know who's coming this weekend as an ally? If people say no, I won't tell you. It's not Missy. Oh my God, the Missy.
Well, I was going to say, because isn't Missy, like, Missy's been presented as an enemy so far.
It's Osgood. Not Oswin. Oswin is Clara.
Who's Osgood?
Osgood. Osgood, who was in the 50th? The one with the inhaler? Sort of thing. You know, when she couldn't breathe? Osgood.
Oh, okay. I suppose she was in the trailer.
Yes. Osgood is coming this weekend, and as if that wasn't exciting a night, Kate is coming next weekend.
Fine. I will get the art then. Fine. If it hasn't got a spoiler in, I will get it. Fine.
No, I wouldn't be allowed to show it if it was spoilery. It's already been seen.
Spoiler. I would throw down and I would be like, what the hell?
I can't show Kate yet. She hasn't even been drawn yet. But yes, we've listened. Osgood and Kate are finally coming to Legacy. We're very excited.
Do you think they should have named them things that didn't start with the word Oz because it's confusing?
Oz doesn't even have a last name in canon, as best I can tell.
Oh. Isn't she just kind of known as Scarf Asthma Girl?
Yes, exactly. we're really excited. I think it's awesome.
Cool. Well, I've added them. I've downloaded them grudgingly. Spoilerfuls then. And
that's not a spoiler.
I'm ready to show them.
Surely you saw the trailer, right?
Well, not everyone does. Some people pause. Some people pause it at the end of the episodes. I'm looking out for the fan.
You should give everyone a warning before you put it on screen, so they could sort of avert thy eyes if they don't want to see.
Well, we've told them who it is now.
No, but I mean to see the picture.
Well, we know what she looks like.
Well, you don't know what she looked like in that if you didn't watch the trailer, do you? No.
I assume she wears a white jacket and a scarf. She was wearing a white jacket and a scarf.
No, it's a different outfit.
Okay. No scarf?
No.
Spoiler! You spoiled this again, Susan! Why? You told us there was no scarf. God, why would you do this?
No, I think Osgood's her first name. Someone's asking if it's a last name. I think it's a first name. It's just Osgood. It's just like...
Who names that kid
like,
Osgood?
Like Prince or Madonna. She's just Osgood.
No, that Osgood is not a name. I'm going to Google baby names Osgood. Baby names Oz. How do you even spell Oz? Yeah, Osgo.
I don't want to say what she's wearing now because you're going to say I'm spoiling again. But people are saying it in the channel because everybody knows. Spoiler! Everyone else watched the trailer.
Osgood. The name Osgood is a baby boy name. It is a Norse name meaning a divine goth. Oh, that's amazing.
A divine goth. Maybe
a divine
maybe
goth.
Should make her ability divine goth.
Yeah, and just redo her whole costume in black.
Exactly. Her ability, we think, we do have like text limitations, and so we're trying to make sure it's not too long, but we want to call her ability Prayer for the Doctor, since she was very fond of sort of, you know, praying to the doctor. She had like this hero worship thing, according to to TARDIS Wiki, which we thought was interesting.
She prayed to the Doctor?
Yeah.
I don't remember this.
In the 50th, she's just like, please save us or whatever. She sort of praised him.
Ooh.
Read the TARDIS
Wiki. I'm going to have to go and rewatch the 50th.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, but no spoilers. I'm not saying a damn thing about what little I know of what's coming. You know, she's just a character that has existed before in canon. No spoilers there.
Well, it's good we haven't got Pete here. Otherwise, Pete would be kind of like, so what happens is, and then after that, this happens, and the whole plan for season 9 is this. And then we'd all sit there going, thanks, Pete. Don't need to watch that now. Cheers. Appreciate it. So, yeah, I think we should like have a ban on Pete until the finale's finished.
Oh, you're funny.
No. I speak the truth. I speak from experience.
We have such a cool weekend coming. Like, have you seen the newsletter? Do you see all the stuff that's coming?
Yeah, you're at a I wouldn't say convent, but I don't mean a convent because that's where nuns goes. You're at a conference, a festival, a comic con, a thing. You're at a festival thing.
No? I'm talking about content this weekend. We have five.
Oh, sorry, I thought
challenge levels are coming.
Oh yeah. Sorry. I thought I read the newsletter, but I thought you were visiting the thing this week.
No, that's coming into. We're not actually going to be at either of them. We can't really get away. But Drew from Gallifrey Pirate Radio is going to be giving out ribbons and some codes and stuff at.
From a pirate radio station.
Yeah.
From you're supporting pirate radio stations and giving out spoilers for Doctor Who, Susan. Oh, what happened to you? I remember when you obeyed the rules.
I'm just a tiny rebel. That's all.
That's true. That's true. Okay, fair enough. The clue should have been in the name.
Exactly.
So, what is pirate? Is that a website?
Yeah, it's a podcast that we've participated in before. They're great, and so they're giving out the ribbons and. They're going to be giving out some codes, and then the Long Island Convention. Has put us in the brochure. This is really lovely black and white picture that we designed for them in the brochure that will give you access to, what is it? It's Colin Baker and Paul McGann and Capaldi, because Colin and Paul are both going to be there. And then when you check in, you'll get, this is really cute, it's a scavenger hunt. You'll get half of a code, and there are codes for, it's five different doctors and their portrait costumes if they're available. And so you have to figure out who has the other half of your code.
Oh, yeah, I remember this. Yeah, you have to go around.
So they're doing that, and then we're all
meeting and greeting everyone. Where's my code?
Yeah, and then their silent auction for charity. They're going to give away a code that unlocks everything in the game other than the expert mode characters. And we're doing that.
Whoa, that's a hell of a
right?
code.
And we're doing that at the Chicago Doctor Who convention as well this month.
Cool. Hmm.
So that's on you. But no, this weekend we have five new challenge levels. People are asking for challenge levels. We have five of them, and that are all tuned to various levels of gameplay. I think the easiest of them is tuned to someone who is midway through the first season of the game, and the hardest is tuned towards like end of season 5.
That's a cool idea. So challenges for people throughout the game.
Yeah, and I think at least a couple of them are very Halloween-y. I think one is called like Kill the Halloween or something like that. And so we have that. And then we have two fan area levels coming this week.
Hang on. Whoa. Dialogue.
Oh.
We just completed a level.
Go on.
Got some dialogue.
Go on, read it.
I'm just gonna, you know, breathe in deeply to like get us prepared for this.
And as they fell, it came to me. That fateful trip, the manor house, the Oregon, and him. I knew what we needed to do. These are not the droids you are looking for.
There we are. Good. I've now completed the level. Please continue.
All right. So Fan Area Rusty is coming this weekend, which should have been last weekend. I apologize. And then we have a special Halloween level just for people in the fan area that is going to unlock, and Addie's going to show this one off too. The Web of Fear black and white costume for the TARDIS, which I think is pretty awesome.
That is
and
pretty
Halloween-y.
Awesome. Cool. Would you like me to show the artwork now
show it.
Later in the
show?
Show
it. Show the Halloween-y TARDIS. It'll get everyone in the mood for Halloween.
In fact, tomorrow night, we have a... we're having a little Halloween stream here tomorrow night about 8 o'clock.
Oh, nice.
Me and Claire are going to do silly things. Speaking of different coloured TARDIS, I found this one earlier because I was looking around. This is... I've always been kind of joking about it, but this is, of course, this is the actual footage of the Happiness Patrol painting the TARDIS pink. Yeah, doesn't it look beautiful? There it is. It's a pink TARDIS. It's amazing. It's amazing. And look, you can get a pink TARDIS keyring, so you can be feminine and sci-fi-rific all at the same time.
Awesome. I've been wanting to put the pink TARDIS out. We thought it'd be kind of a cool thing for, you know, breast cancer, you know, month.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Well, WWE or wrestling stuff's doing all that at the moment, isn't it? Going crazy with breast
is
cancer.
It now?
So it's the kind of thing that lots of organizations do.
Yeah, is it now? The pink month, is it now?
I don't know if it's now, but certainly the wrestling stuff is doing it right now. Oh, cool. There's the ignore that code, guys. That was from last week. So that won't work anymore. Oh, there's the left bricks that I pinked up. Right. What would you like me to show first?
Let's see the TARDIS.
Let's see the TARDIS. How did your conversation with Pete go last week? Because you asked him if you could do something on stream and he wasn't particularly chuffed and he said you were going to discuss
it. Oh, no. Did that I don't go? Know what he was talking about. No, it's fine. It's on. Hashtag knock knock is ongoing, and Lee's poor little wrists are killing him from typing codes today. So what we came up with last week and are indeed doing is, if you're on Twitter, and apologies if you're not, you need to tweet hashtag knock knock and hashtag DW legacy, and if you're lucky, Lee will send you a trick or treat reward. We're not going to get to everyone, though. We are really trying to. Maybe we will, but we have tons and tons of codes that we've cut for different things, so it's random what you get. And yeah. So what do you?
Awesome.
And there's the TARDIS covered in webbing.
Yep, the Web of Fear TARDIS. Obviously, that's the Yeti one. It's a Patrick Troughton one. It's very, very good. It was one of the ones where they lost some episodes, and then they rediscovered some of them, and they re-released it in a DVD, and I got that for Clara for her birthday, and it's good. It was we didn't know how much we were going to like an old classic Doctor, but it was it was good fun, and we really did enjoy it, and it made us want to watch more. So that's definitely a plus. So yeah. A web covered TARDIS. Oh, that one, because it's kind of grayscale as well, that would go really nicely in a team of experts as well.
That's a good point. Because
you know how they're black and white, so it would you could have a nice monochrome team there. If any of you are enjoying tonight's stream, well, I'm sure you're all enjoying tonight's stream, but if you are particularly enjoying it and would like to donate to the channel, there is a donate button underneath. It's completely optional. You never have to use it, but it is there if you wish to use it. And I've got the program up this week, so if you do donate, I will put whatever message you put, I will get up on the stream, up on the screen, so everyone can see it. But obviously that is completely optional. Shall I put another one
up? Why don't you show off Rusty, actually, as well? I think
Rusty.
I put it on Facebook.
So this is the train from Starlight Express, yeah?
This is what... This is Rusty, the Dalek from Into the Dalek, which people have been asking for a while.
I am a good Dalek. There he is.
I am going to be a Dalek for Halloween, by the way.
No way.
I am. I'm going to be a gold Dalek.
An actual Dalek.
Yes. Lanyon's very excited about that.
So he should be. How do I zoom in? Why can I not zoom in?
I think they did a great job on Rusty, though. I'm pretty happy about that.
There must be a way that I can zoom in. Why am I being thick here? No, that's just the position. Hang on. If I do that. No, that just cuts bits of it off. God, how do I zoom in? I can spin the thing. No. I'm spinning Rusty around like some sort of thing. Oh, God. No, not that one. Whoa. Not that one either. Nope, that moves him around. No, that's just stupid. Stop it. Stop it. Oh, God, that's squishing him. I don't know how you zoom in. That's the way to zoom in.
Upside down and backwards.
Oh, God, help me. I'm screwing everything up. What? No. Oh, fine. Look, there you go. There's Rusty. You can see him from a distance. Isn't that lovely?
Squished.
He's now unsquished.
Yes.
Right, okay, we'll forget that ever happened.
Now he's stretched.
There must be a way. I've unstretched him. He's beautiful. He's back to his... good gold bally self.
On my screen, it's still showing weird things happening.
Oh.
There we go. He's back to normal.
It's not that weird. It's not that weird.
Strange.
So what ability will he have?
That's a good question. You know, when Lee pops on soon, he can tell us. I don't remember. Oh, I know what it's called. It's something to do with the birth of a star.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was something to do with that. I just don't remember what.
Because you can now almost put together a. Obviously, they're all allies, in quotes. But you've definitely now got the opportunity to put in a an enemy's team, you know, because you've got Rusty, you've got Handles, you've got Strax, you've got the Silence. You could put an Adipose in. You know, you could make quite a cool
team.
Monsters
yeah.
group.
We always hope to do that. Oh. You know, it's always a matter of finding ones who make sense within the canon of the universe. You know, so we're always looking for opportunities to do that. We are going to try and get more of the Daleks in. I know that, like, Shuri and some others have suggested Alpha, Beta, and Omega. So there are definitely some others out there that we could get in.
Awesome. Yeah. Cool. We're going to go to commercial. And when we get back, we have some more artwork for you and some giveaways and some more great gameplay. So we will see you in 60. Hello, everybody. We are back. So we have a few more pieces of artwork to show you before we carry on. But tonight's giveaway is going to be my team of the week. So if you haven't got Tom yet, he's in there. It's also got young Sarah Jane. It's got the TARDIS. It's got... I forgot the other ones. It's got K-9. It's got the Brigadier. If you haven't got him, he's a rare character. And, of course, Clara is there as well, who you may not have unlocked. If you stick around towards the end of the show, we'll be giving away two copies of that entire team. We're using Adigold, and you're earning one Adigold every 5 minutes you are watching the stream. So let's get back to our little preview shots, shall we? So... Who shall we bring in now?
I think it's Osgood, right?
Okay, so if you don't want to be spoiled as to what Osgood looks like in the upcoming episode, I suggest you to look away from your monitors for the next 60 seconds or so. But obviously she's a character we've seen before, so probably isn't a major one. So look away now, because it's appearing on the stream now. And we can now describe in detail what she looks like. So everyone will know. Maybe we should talk about it without talking about it. So just in case there is anyone not looking at the stream, we should, you know, we don't spoil anything away. I like the
hair
appendages to the face, the accessories. They've got her demeanor of being a bit awkward,
a bit nerdy,
and. Yeah, it's kind of nerdy. Like she kind of doesn't know how to be feminine, but so she just ends up kind of looking a bit kind of frumpy. But they've got that kind of look well, you know, in that she's still does care what she looks like.
I think she looks cool. I think it's a flattering drawing too. Oh, yeah, thank you, Temple. No, well, glad you like it.
Which is very, very cool.
Yes, and I'm assuming everyone's going to start nagging us now for the scarf costume. I'm fully expecting it. I'm waiting, ready.
Good, good.
Oh, and next why don't we show and get it off the screen for people who are, you know, spoiler free, let's show the new Rory the Centaurian costume that was funded by the community, which is also coming out this weekend.
Okay, so if you don't want to see Aurora the Centurion, continue to look away now, although I suppose we have it. He's not likely to return to Doctor Who anytime soon. Here he is. 3, 2, 1, boom! On the screen, we've got a little Rory.
This is a really cool action shot. I'm really happy about this one, actually.
So remind us what crowdfunding is and why you did it for these costumes.
Well, we get asked all the time for the like ungodly thousands of costumes over the 50 years, but you know, we only have so much bandwidth to get stuff done. So what we said was if people wanted to specifically sort of basically help us to fund the sort of an ancillary series of costumes, that we'd get some outsourcing done so that we could sort of up the pace on those. And so the first of these was Rory, which was fully funded within a day, which is awesome. And so he's going to come out this weekend.
In a day?
Yeah.
Wow.
And so he's going to come out this weekend, and then we're still figuring out the next costume. I think Lee is thinking that the next costume should be a classic. I know we don't have that many classic characters in, but you know, we do have some to choose from between like young Sarah Jane and Ace and all the classic doctors. So perhaps it'll be something like that, or maybe one of the earlier versions of K-9. You know, there are the other versions of K-9. So something like that, I think it'd be cool to get something classic in.
You could give yourself a massive headache by trying to get an alternative Tom Baker outfit.
Yeah.
Get that approved.
True.
Because technically, at the very beginning of Tom, he dresses up in about 4 or 5 different outfits, doesn't he? Just as he, to try and find his look, including like a Viking and a Scot and various things. They could be quite fun.
Amy Kissogram was the second choice, but I think we'd really like to sort of just alternate things and get something classic in next.
Classic and perhaps classy, you know.
Classy, yeah. You know what? I'd love to see it be like a Peter Davison costume, because he doesn't have any costumes yet.
That's true. Does he ever wear anything else?
I
don't know. Let's go to Google. Peter Davison, I always get that one wrong. Alternate costume. I don't know why I'm putting alternate costume in there, because that's not going to come up with anything. But let's have a look. Alternate outfit. Oh no, Google is frozen. A broken Google. It looks that sometimes his jacket looks slightly lighter than others. But I'm not sure I'm going to call that an alternate costume. Let me take you across to my desktop so you guys can see what I'm looking at. Hang on. There's a picture of him here wearing a cloaky thing. There you go. You can put him in a cloaky thing. Wow, there's a young-looking Peter Capaldi. It's always a little bit worrying doing a live Google search on stream, because you never can be entirely sure when boobs are going to come up. Oh, in fact, there's Perry. So there they probably are. Are you still there? Am I talking to myself? Hello? Hello? Yep. Alone. You can have hat on, hat off. That's probably about as far as it goes. Yep, there is a problem with this call. We've lost to Susan. Ah, but she says call her somewhere else. So I shall call her on Lee's phone.
Hello?
Hello. I see you ran away from us. There doesn't appear to be any alternative Peter Davison costumes. Hello? Can you not hear me? Well, I can hear you, even if you can't hear me.
I got it in the wrong chat. I'm having loads of technical issues. I haven't had my computer crash since I bought it. That was weird.
There doesn't appear to be any alternative Peter Davison costumes from just a quick Google.
Really?
He does occasionally wear the hat, and he does occasionally not wear the hat.
Huh.
The other one I found was, there's a picture of him kind of wearing some weird kind of outfit, but I don't know what it is.
Huh. Weird, I'm not like, a big Peter Davison expert, so I haven't really seen that much Peter Davison.
He must have done something at some
point. There would be his regeneration outfit, like someone just said, him wearing Tom Baker's clothing. That'd be kind of cool. Someone just said Harlequin outfit from Black Orchid.
Oh. People are more knowledgeable
than
I.
Cricket here.
Anyway,
that's a great idea.
I'm about to actually play with Tom, because it appears that it's actually going to let me use the character this time. It's not changing the level. So I think if we're actually going to actually use Tom, we should, any excuse to play the Team of the Week song for the second time, don't you think?
I absolutely think so, yes.
So here we go. Get ready to sing along, everyone. Here we go. The team of the week song. Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Sorry. I screwed up. Here is the team of the week song for the second time. Please enjoy and sing along.
You gotta try the team of the week. Team of the week. If you're out of luck and your strategy sucks and there's something new you seek, try the team of the week. Yeah, the team of the week. Try the team of the week, people. It'll make you feel good inside.
I love it. It's ridiculously vain. I shouldn't love it because I made it, but I'd love it. I don't even care. apparently people are shouting at me. Yes, apparently it's a Black Orchid costume. I do look at the chat. I just sometimes forget to look at the chat, but I do look at it. You could be a bit mean to Peter Davison because there was that one, you know, when he came back for the charity special and had a conversation with David Tennant's doctor. Have you seen that one?
No.
Oh. Well, you could have an old Peter Davison.
Nice. I'm having a look at it. I like the... Oh, no, hang on a second. I'm trying to look up the Black Rocket costume.
It was cool. It was very cool, actually. It was a charity thing, and it was just one... It was like a five-minute thing that was shown on Children in Need one year, and it was the Tennant Doctor, and they had a... You know, the TARDIS kind of half-crashed, and then he accidentally crossed his own timeline, or whatever they do in Doctor Who to explain these things, and the Peter Davison Doctor appeared there but looking old, and they just kind of chatted for 5 minutes. And it started off with them bickering and yelling at each other and ended up with quite a touching little bit of dialogue between them. And then he disappeared. But it actually works completely independently of the charity thing. So I would, if you've never seen it, go and check it out after the show. It's very, very good.
Very cool.
Just type David Taven, Peter Davison, Children in Need, something like that. And, it'll come out. It'll make you feel good inside.
I like the idea of the bathroom from Black Rocket. That's pretty cool. Have you seen the bathroom?
Did you guys talk any more about the Children in Need thing that we mentioned last week?
No, actually, that's a good point. No, we haven't. I do need to. We had so many other things going on this week that I haven't had a chance to talk about that. We are. Let's see what else is going on. We're going to be launching another gem theme this weekend, which is going to be a Cyberman gem theme because of the Cyberman episode that's coming up. So that's cool. That's coming this weekend. And the gem skin contest, if anyone still wants to throw their design in, you got till tomorrow to send it.
One day.
And there's some really cool ones. It's actually going to be a really hard decision. I love some of the ones that came through yesterday in particular. Really neat.
And even better news, I have a plan to take down the Toclophane. To take on an army, we don't need an army, but we do need to be able to think like one. We need a great military mind.
There was a blur as the doctors, if all immediately knew what he was suggesting and knew what they had to do in order to act on it, moved towards the center console. Switches were flipped, lights blinked and pulsed, and I held on tightly as, once again, we dematerialized. Everything shifted around me, and I felt, as I did with every leap through time and space, that a small part of me had been left behind. Oh, it's Captain Jack. That's amazing. And who would this great mind be, Doctor? In fact, you should do Captain Jack because, you know, you're American. So you need to say, and who would this great mind be, Doctor? Please, repeat.
Who would this great mind be, Doctor?
That's uncanny. It's like Jack is right here.
His name is Alistair Gordon Lethbridge Stewart. Brigadier Alistair Gordon Lethbridge Stewart. And I have an idea about how we can get him here. We need some bits and pieces to build a machine. We can smash down the walls between his timeline and this one.
I mean, it's Rory. How do you do Rory's voice? She's just kind of like weak and pathetic, isn't it? But like heroic a little bit. Kind of like, oh, in fact, we need someone kind of weedy and pathetic to do Rory's voice. Is Leah around?
Oh.
No? Okay, fine. Couldn't we just pick him up in the TARDIS? If you've spent so much time with him, it should be easy to track him down.
That does not sound sadly, anything it's like not Rory. Going to...
Shut up, Susan. sadly, it's not going to be anywhere as easy as that, Rory. His timeline and mine are heavily intertwined with... I am doing dialogue with the Time Vortex. Dematerialized around us, forcibly landing a TARDIS with so many of my regenerations on board, simply near the Brigadier, is simply suicide. All right, here's Jenny. You can be Jenny. You need to say, so what do we need to build in order to get him to us? A little bit louder. A little bit more Susan-y. Jenny.
What am I? I'm on a different screen for you. It hasn't caught up with me yet.
I've just told you the line. Come on. So what do we need to build in order to get him to us in a suit? You need to do it in a London, like, so what do we need to build in order to get him to us?
I can't possibly have went up that. That was perfect.
No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't. Hang on. Let me share the screen with you so you can be fully up to date. And therefore, if I need you to do any...
So what do we need to build in order to get him to us? Take two. So what do we need...
excuse me, London accent, please. So, what do we need in order to
get him to us?
Oh, that was better. Oh, I like that. That was good. That was good. Let me share the screen with you, and then be a little more up to date. There we go. Right dialogue. Oh, that's the old first Doctor. His voice was like very, very, very posh, but old. I don't think you can do that one. A piece of very specific. I just need to do a voice of someone that's about to die.
Is De Niro doing William Hartnell?
Probably.
There was that first episode, you know, where he was like, it was a little bit mafia-ish.
True. A piece of very specific and technical time apparatus, young lady, must be built quickly. Oh God, it's Matt Smith. I can't do Matt Smith. You just need to like, it's all on the fingers. You don't actually need any dialogue. You just need fingers going all the time. First thing we need is like casing. We need a specific metal, one with very interesting properties, something like that. Even in my travels, I haven't seen a lot of it. Trinamo! But the silent bishops use it in the construction of their confessional chambers. We need to find a silent ship, which, if our calculations are correct, should be just outside these doors. Play with my bow tie and stuff. There we go. Now we can start the level. Whew. Wow, we got a bit of a workout there. Good. You got a round of applause for your Susan, for your Jenny impression, boy. No, apparently you didn't. You did. Hello.
Hello.
Wow, that's an amazing impression of the first Doctor. It's kind of like old and a little bit kind of like there's like vulnerability in your voice, and it's like doing that kind of woggle wobble thing. That's really
wise.
Good. Do that again, Susan.
You mean wise? That's what's in my voice.
Yes, yes. It's like wisdom. So when's Lee getting here?
So what have you done so far? What have I missed?
We made a Tom Baker team, and we played Team of the Week twice because it's an awesome song, and we showed off the artwork for Osgood and the TARDIS. No, yeah, the web TARDIS and Rusty and something else that I've forgotten, and... We read out your dialogue.
We have so many levels coming this week. That's all I've done this week. All I've done is make levels. Levels after level after level after level.
Tell us about the levels then. We want to hear it. Make us excited. Make us go, oh my God, I can't wait to play these
levels. I have a list here somewhere.
Ooh.
I do.
A list.
There were so many levels. We had to start having these running lists of where we were with each one. So we have the three Dark Water levels coming alongside the new episode. So we have a hard, a medium, and an easy. And that's set at a location in London and with lots of enemies flooding at you. I don't want to say what it is because I don't want to spoil anything in the episode. People have been...
Yeah, if you spoil the episode, I will throw down.
Yeah, that's vague enough, but it's good. It's been a really fun level to put together. And that drops, of course, Osgood, who I know a lot of people have been waiting for. And we're really excited about it. And the art, I love the art. They did a really good job with it. In the fan area... We have the boarding of the Aristotle, a new hard mode level, which drops Fan Rusty. And then we have
the boarding of the Aristotle. What's that from? I don't know that one.
Well, it's just it's the Into the Dalek episode. The ship they were on was called the Aristotle.
Oh, right. So the battle between the Dalek and the soldiers.
Yeah. So we've made a level where you fight Time War Daleks, and at the end of there, Fan Rusty drops. And then cool. This week, that was supposed to be in last weekend, and it slipped because things have been getting crazy busy. And then the other one coming this week to the fan area is one based on the Deadly Assassin, which drops the web TARDIS and has you fighting Falling Masonry and the Crispy Master in the on Gallifrey.
You have to fight the Falling Masonry.
Have you seen the scene where the Crispy Master and the Doctor fight in the Panopticon next to the big black obelisk?
I have not, but now I sound like I need to. If they fight masonry.
Just clobbered by masonry, and I was like, we should just make some rocks and have you fight loads of rocks. They try to kill you, and then you fight the assassin. Anyway, they're coming too. And then we have five new challenge area levels in order.
Oh, apparently, hang on. Sorry, someone's telling me that the game audio is off. Was the game audio one before? And I'll disconnect it and bring it back. Hopefully that'll then bring the game audio. If not, you might just have to live without it, I'm afraid.
Why do people say I sound ill? I don't sound ill. I'll be louder. Is that less ill?
No, it's not your volume. I think it's the fact that rather than going, you know, like, kind of like, hi, I'm on the stream.
And somebody
else
said I sound sick. I'm tired because I've been cranking levels out all week. Anyway, the rest of the levels, I'll try to be a bit more peppy. Challenge number 5, which is early season 6, called Kill the Halloween. That drops a time crystal. Challenge number 6, mid-season 6, the 7th Doctor challenge number 1. All these drop a time crystal, actually. Challenge 7, late season 6, the time of Halloween. Challenge 8, early season 5, the 3rd Doctor challenge number 1. And then challenge 9, which is late season 5, the deadly Halloween. So we have a few Halloween levels.
Oh, I see what you've done. You've taken like famous Doctor Who episodes and replaced the word Doctor with Halloween, time of Halloween, day of the Halloween, night
close.
Of Halloween.
No, close, but not. Just replaced a word. So we have 10 levels coming this week. 10 levels.
Whoa. 10 levels?
That wasn't the plan. It just got out of hand during midweek and more cool things came up. So we just kept making things. And I sat and sent out Twitter codes to about a million people earlier over an hour to the point where my arm was aching and I had to stop. But we are sending out random Twitter codes to anyone who does I'm sure Susan's pitched this already, the whole knock-knock thing we're doing. And I'll get back to that later.
Absolutely. Knock-knock and Doctor Who Legacy. Is that the combination they need
to use?
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, DW Legacy. So that's
and you'll get some goodies coming your way. Right, let's get the giveaway started and then we can carry on talking while we go to commercial, and then we'll give some more stuff. So guys, this is going to be an Addy Gold giveaway for today's team of the week, which you can see just on my right hand side here. The 4th Doctor is in it, young Sarah Jane, K9, the TARDIS, the Brigadier, and Clara is my team of the week. Yeah, Lee, I struggled with my 6th member and I decided to go for Clara because technically she's the girl who saved the Doctor. So she's actually in all of their timelines. Do you think I got away with that?
I did listen to the first 10 minutes prior to run out. So I did hear that whole thing.
Who would you have stuck in for yourself?
I would back you up. I think Clara's fine, yeah.
She works. Although someone did point out that Tom did use Bessie, so I might have gone Bessie if I thought about it. So do check your Addy Gold, and I will start the giveaway right now. We've got 2 copies of this team to give away, courtesy of Susan Lee and Tiny Rebel Games. As usual, you can buy as many raffle tickets as you want, and we'll draw 2 raffle tickets at random just before the end of the show, and you can get your the winners. Obviously, the more tickets you buy, the more chances you will be a winner. You must be following the channel. If you're not a follower of the channel, but luckily, like, Jetta now is, he is now eligible to win. You need to buy a ticket, you need to just type !! raffle ticket space and then the number of tickets you want. As you can see, Astragali has just done so then, to get your tickets in if you'd like to win. And the last thing I'll say before we go to commercial is, if you've got any questions for Susan and or Lee or myself, use !! question, ask your question, and I will ask Lee your questions in about 5 minutes before the end of the show. We are going to commercial, and when we come back, we shall have giveaways, we shall have gossip, and of course, we shall have gameplay. Back in a sec. And hello. We are back, ladies and gentlemen. We are currently in the middle of a giveaway for the team of the week. You can see on your right, Fourth Doctor, Young Sarah Jane, K9, the TARDIS, the Brigadier, and Clara. Ask the mods if you're not sure how to enter the giveaway, but essentially it's exclamation mark raffle ticket and the number of tickets that you want. We will close the giveaway in about 8 minutes time, which is when we hit 9 o'clock UK time. Now, Lee and or Susan, help me with this, how this is. Does your time zone change as well next week to get us back into sync, or do Americans not change time zone? Because I was a bit confused.
It does change back. Is it? It's either 7 or 14 days later. It's either next weekend. I haven't looked yet. I know it lags quite a little bit.
Next week, of course, is quite an exciting stream because you're in charge, aren't you?
I am. Is next week the one you can't make?
Indeed. Well, I might be able to make it.
Oh, but remotely,
but it's probably safer if you host it. We're moving house on the Friday, so the chances are most things will be packed up. So I might be able to do a and like phone in on Skype and be like, all right. And
it'll be fun. You know, I'll forget this until 10 minutes before the stream starts. We'll make it fun. It'll be, we won't be able to talk about anything to do with the last episode. It'll be fun. We'll find something interesting to do that day.
Oh, I'm sure it'll be an awesome stream. You know, the ones you've done before were very professional. I can trust you with the channel for the night. It'll be cool. So it'll still be at 8 o'clock UK time, people, next week, but it'll be hosted by Lee and Susan, which is quite cool. Although you'll have to work out how you're going to do giveaways and stuff like that. give you something else to add to your list of things to do. You could just cheat, though, couldn't you? You could just go, let's just do a code that everyone can have, and then we can just give it out and not have to work out the giveaway system.
Exactly.
So you have a list. Give us news. Tell us everything.
For some reason, Susan was at my computer when I came back in, and there's all these there's all windows open in my browser. They seem to be like Fifth Doctor outfits or something. What were you guys up to while I wasn't
here? The suggestion was to have a new costume, like to be different from after Rory's Centurion, and she suggested maybe doing something for the Fifth Doctor, as he doesn't get much love. But then it turns out he never really wore anything other than a cricket hat.
Is something in him in a dressing gown?
I'm not sure that's from the same show. I think someone said there was a dark orchid costume.
Somebody just tweeted 36 seconds ago, one from Warriors of the Deep where he's in a spacesuit. It looks quite neat. We do need more spacesuits.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
We only have 100 different allies in spacesuits. Classic spacesuit, though. Not orange.
Then we can have then I can have a team of the week for spacesuits.
Yeah, we should
make it so.
She's handing me, she's handing me a list of things, and I don't know what she's talked about.
If you start telling us, and if you start telling us stuff that we've already said, I'll make a subtle comment that might redirect you.
You'll just start screaming, no!
Stop. Heard it! There we go.
So look, BBC America, during the final episode of the season, which is a week and a half away, BBC America have been amazing and they've given us some screen space. So during the episode, there'll be at the bottom of the screen where things pop up? I think they call them bugs in TV speak lingo. I think somebody told me in a meeting once. They pop up and it's a couple of lines of text, maybe a picture of a car or another character from a different TV series, you know, that sort of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We get one of these bugs for Legacy, so it's going to pop up, it'll talk about Legacy, and then it'll give a code for some stuff. So that's awesome.
Yeah, it is. That's good. If that's during the finale in America, that's going to get you some serious.
Well, that's what we hope. So once again, thank
although
you.
Although I think if you tried the same trick in the UK, you'd get a million people going, what have you done to my show? Putting adverts over it.
I think that's probably exactly what would happen. And the Cardiff exhibition down the Cardiff Bay, the amazing, amazing Doctor Who exhibition, which any Whovian should take a pilgrimage to at least once a year, if they're anywhere remotely close to it, is about to relaunch or has just relaunched.
It just opened.
With a brand new 12th Doctor storyline, which is cool. And
I think Snowjoke went there. I think it was Snowjoke. I saw someone on Facebook. Snowjoke, are you here? Did you go? Snowjoke. No, I can't see Snowjoke. She's probably still there. people are going already.
We're in discussion with them. We've been talking to Peter about doing some levels based on that, and maybe some costumes based on the exhibition that we put it again.
That's so cool.
We'd be quite cool.
The Addy meet is in mid February, and we now have, I think it's 15 people, maybe more now, from the posse or meeting, and we're all going to go to Cardiff for a couple of days, and we're going to do the Doctor Who exhibition, hopefully the TARDIS tour if it's available that day, a walking Doctor Who tour, and get to know each other a little bit as well, which is very, very exciting. We've got people coming from Europe, people coming from America, and of course me, who's coming from Watford.
Glamorous, glamorous Watford.
I know which I'm more excited about. yeah, so the Addy meet, and obviously if you guys can jet halfway across the world, you'd be more than welcome.
Yes, I'll get on there, yeah.
Add it to your list.
Do we have some questions? Should we launch into questions?
We've got loads of questions, and we can carry on doing announcements. Endhaven, this is probably a big question. What will you do after season 8 is over?
That's a great question. Let's have a look. What have we got lined up? So let's have a look. During November, we want to try to get the first chapter of Big Ronnie Inside Out, which is our new side story in the game. And it's getting closer. There was actually some movement on that today. We're getting really close. So it should be up. Maybe by next week.
I'm fighting a really tiny silence. I'm fighting like a little dwarf silence. That's awesome.
So that's.
I think he's supposed to be.
Yeah.
I think he's supposed to be far away. I think it's perspective. But I just hope I can pick him up, and I'd put him in my pocket, and then I'd forget about him. How cool would that be? And then later in the day, I'd be like, what's that little lump in my pocket? Oh, look, it's a silence. And then I put it back and I'd forget about it. And then later in the day, I'd be like, what's this lump in my pocket? And I'd pick it up and it would be a silence. And I'd be like, oh my goodness, that's amazing. And I'd put it back in my pocket and then I'd forget about it. And then later in the day, I'd be like, what's this lump in my pocket? And I'd be like, oh my God, it's a silence. It'd be amazing. They should make an episode about that. Hi.
Are you done now?
To be honest, I can carry on. I think it's quite funny.
I don't know where I was before you went off on small things, Chad. What was I saying before? See, you do this. You start going on about small things or cows or Father Ted, and then I just completely lose all track.
They were talking about Father Ted in the channel the other day. And so I said, someone said, I don't really like it. And I was like, you will. And they're like, I don't. And I was like, you will, you will, you will. And they didn't know what I was talking about. And I was like, that thing. Ah.
Wait, there was a question. What was the question? Oh, what do we do next? Okay, so Big Ronnie Inside November.
What do we do next? I
am trying. We would really, really like to, before the 1 year anniversary, add a new set of story levels, which add the 12th Doctor and the 4th Doctor to the storyline before our anniversary. So we're Doctor complete by the end of November, which would be a nice milestone to be by the first anniversary. So I've written some new script, and that has been sent to the BBC. So we'll see. Hopefully get that out. Bigger on the inside.
Oh, this means I can start doing 4th Doctor impressions as well, which is like kind of big and boomy and lots of laughing. Wow, that's awesome. Yeah, write me some dialogue that I can do. Please. Well, the
Bigger on the Inside follows... It primarily follows five or six doctors, and each of them gets, you know, like 20 levels each, gets a good chunk of screen time where you follow them during that bit of the story.
Good. It's really tricky to do the 4th Doctor without accidentally sounding like Brian Blessed.
You should try. I think you should do everything you do as a doctor from now on.
There was this show. It was a really cool show. You might have seen it. It had a half an hour episode on each doctor, and it was called like Meet the Doctors or something like that. And they basically did a quick overview to each doctor, and they had an interview with each doctor. I think they had most of them, which is impressive in most of the shows. And they had Tom, who's obviously quite old now, and he's just reached that point of just laughing at his own story. So he just kind of, and then we went down the hallway, and and he never finishes the story. He just laughs. I'm going to try it. When I reach a certain age, I'm just not even going to bother with punchlines anymore. I'm just going to start stories and then, then I'll just laugh. It'll be great. But I'm looking forward to your dialogue and the adventure. It sounds cool.
So November is the 1 year anniversary of the game, and we're going to probably give away something awesome. We're talking about that now. What can we do for our 1 year anniversary? And we want to get a new story in, and I want to get the first chapter of Bigger on the Inside, which is our new side story that's coming in 4 chapters over the next few months. In by the 1 year anniversary, so that's November. So that's a load of stuff that I have to get in the next 30 days on top of the last 2 weeks of the season. So it's quite bonkers right now.
On top of eating.
And it's breathing as well. I need to do it at some point.
Yeah, occasional sleep.
And then we hit December. In December, we're going to do, well, if for you guys who've been around for a year now, who followed the game, be part of the community for a year, we're doing our second Advent calendar. So every day during December after Christmas,
I remember that.
Give away
I remember,
something.
That was one of the things that properly got me into the game. It was very, very cool. Lining up, a little something every day.
We're lining up some cool stuff. We're working with the guys who wrote and drew for Engines of War. We're working with the Titan guys. We'll hopefully get a lot of cool stuff coming out that month on top of just, you know, new levels and new characters for the game and the game's art style. Lots of other fun stuff.
So here we go. I'm going to use Tom's ability here. Have a jelly, baby. Convert two random gem colors to another. Would you like to use this ability? Yes, I would. And everything went green. Helpful. That'll get my combo even more combo-y.
So that's December. And then January, we want to start the next chapter of the game, which is the storyline, Chapter 4. And instead of us waiting months and releasing a big chunk of content, we want to try to get 3 or 4 levels out every week forever. We want to get down to a sort of that cadence of, you know, release schedule where just every week a bunch of new story comes out, new characters come out, and the story just progresses every week. Because we really like putting out stuff every week during, you know, alongside the season of the show. And we want to do that with the main game as well on the storyline. So we just have piles of stuff coming. We're really excited. We have loads on the table.
Tons.
Our calendar of stuff and promotions and you know, content for the game is now full till about March next year. We have so much stuff in production. If you like this game, there's a lot of stuff coming for this game. I'm excited.
And it is now time for the added gold giveaway, which is exciting as well. But the amount of content you guys have got coming out is awesome. Like this game, you know, some games, especially free-to-play games, mobile games, kind of wind down a little bit after, after a certain period of time. But you guys are, you know, it sounds like you're almost increasing. Yeah. I remember, I hope I'm not breaking any rules here by saying this, but I do remember we had a conversation very, very early on where you kind of said that you thought the game might last about a year. But actually, it's... You know, like you said, it's actually bigger, if anything. You know, there's no reason to even think about winding anything down because it's now a far bigger thing than it was when you started, and there's so much more still to include.
The crazy thing. When we started the game, we were like, oh, you know, maybe we'll hit a year. You know, it was like we had, you know, we'd be so lucky if this game's still out in a year's time. And now we're looking quite confidently again at the next year and being like, okay, we might be able to hit 2 years in this with the way things are going, which is amazing. Mm. You know, we can keep doing this and keep supporting this. And at the end of the day, as long as we keep making cool things and people keep buying things in the game, it'll just keep growing. There's no reason for it to stop.
So keep supporting the game, people. If you can afford it, please buy Time Crystals, get in the fan area. If you can't afford it, then please do it. Please, you know, like the game, you know, give it a positive review and stuff, but recommend it to your friends, you know, help us help you and all that kind of stuff. And of course, turn up on Thursdays for the wonderful live stream. Right, the tombola is up. We are giving 2 copies of the team that is in front of you away. And we've got 4,397 tickets sold. Good luck to everyone. And I'm going to pick 2 winners. Our first winner is Neo Incarnate. Congratulations, Neo Incarnate. You are a winner, and I shall make my name across to Lee. Obviously, I stream Doctor Who Legacy on Thursdays, but I stream other games at other times. And if you come, the more stuff you come to, the more added gold you get, and the more the higher chance of winning one of the giveaways goes. Because I know some our winners here are often the regulars, and our second winner is I don't know this one, Doctor Davros. That sounds like a scary combination, doesn't it? What would happen if the 13th Doctor was actually Davros? That would change history, canon, everything forever. Ask Dr. Davros. He knows all about it. Okay, I've messaged your names across to Susan. Congratulations to our winners. Commiserations to our losers. But don't worry, there'll be another giveaway next week. Anyway, we've got a bit of dialogue here. Back to the TARDIS. We have our casing. Time for our next stop. Victory! Level complete. And with a victory, of course, everyone earns an Addy Gold. Would you like another question, Lee, or have you got something else you'd like to
talk about? Just sending the codes out. The codes announced that. Go. What's the next question?
Okay. When is Tom coming to the opening screen? And that's from the Gloam Glozer.
That's a client-side update. I've asked the team the next time we update to get him in. I think our tech team are currently working on memory optimizations to get it more stable on some older hardware. And I think they were aiming to try to put a build out in about 2 weeks' time. So it should go in with that. If not, it should definitely be in by the 1-year anniversary of the game, which is in about a month. So soon, soon we'll get it.
That would be quite a cool way to mark the anniversary, you know, with a new title page and things.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, as soon as we can, over the next month, that should be updated, as well as I mentioned earlier, adding the two final Doctors to the storyline, or at least where we are now.
Let's play Nintendo Eater says, what difficulty will the Halloween level be?
There are a bunch of Halloween levels. Oh, I just closed it. I had it open. I try to space them out a little bit all over the place. So there's a fan area Halloween level, which is hard. You need a level 40 thing. There's a early season 6 Halloween level, which is around level 20. There's a late season 6 Halloween level, which is around level 30. And then there's another hard Halloween level around level 40. So they're spaced out a bit. That's one reason we did so many levels. Is I really wanted to space these out and have them all over the place and have a bit of content for everyone. So we ended up doing a lot more levels than we expected to sort of give everyone a little bit of something.
Thank you. There's various questions insulting my impersonations. I'm obviously not going to read them out because it's just damn rude. Plus, my impersonations are amazing. This is possibly my favorite question of all time.
Oh, no.
And I'm so glad that you're on here to actually answer this question too. Lee, how long will it be until we get the Paul McGann wrapped up in a bedsheet costume added to the game?
With a bedsheet? Where's a bedsheet from? You mean the mortuary thing?
I believe, yes, in the mortuary scene, he runs around a little bit in wearing only a bedsheet, almost Doctor Who nudity.
I don't know. That's a good question. That might be getting
that
a bit niche.
Excellent question.
If I decide over the next, I'll make some unilateral decision just to like make the next month 8th Doctor month and everything is just 8th Doctor, I don't think people would be happy.
Yeah.
As much as I'd love to do that, it would be good to get every. I think we have to jump around a little bit. But maybe for the Advent this year. I want to do a few Doctor outfits. Maybe we'll do some great Christmas ones like that.
It's Halloween tomorrow. They often say, you know, the simplest, best Halloween costume is just sticking a sheet over your head and drawing two eyes on it. I mean, the Eighth Doctor basically did that.
Well, we could do a sort of Christmas Past thing where he could be the ghost of Christmas Past in a bedsheet. We'll try to find, you know.
That's true. You know, come on in. Know me better, man. Sounds just like him. Someone else is insulting my John Pertwee impression. Someone says I sound like Alec Guinness. Right, someone asks about the Twitter thing. Where do we type the Twitter thing? Says RB61111 or something like that. This is obviously a knock knock thing. So do you want to be a bit more specific on actually how people do
send that? Send a tweet which includes hashtag knock knock and hashtag DW legacy, because I search for those two, and if they both come up in a tweet, I just sending codes out. So just tweet anything with those two hashtags in the message, and then it'll be filtered. And I can see it, and I can send things. But you have to be following us, so I can send something back. If you're not following us, I can't send
things back. If you're not following the channel, if you're not following the legacies, don't expect the freebies.
I can't, and some people have direct messaging turned off, so they followed us, and I try to send it back, and I can't. So you need to be able to receive a message from me, which requires you to receive messages and to be following us.
Thank you. Just ignoring all of the can we get a new costume for Rose questions. This is a nice question. Lee, can you make a TARDIS pack? Like one companion is 11th TARDIS, one is the 8th TARDIS. This is true because the TARDIS is always a big blue police box, but it does have minor variations between most Doctors. Not all, but, you know, some of them have different kind of window patterns, different sizes, yada, 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 yada. And I think you actually came a cropper once, didn't it? Because you used the wrong TARDIS design, or you asked to change it or something, weren't you? Because
there are a lot of rules of how the TARDIS looks and acts, and, like, which, if you look on the windows outside, when they glow from the inside, you know, it's a lot of rules. We actually, before Season 8 started, and we started getting really bogged down creating all Season 8 stuff, I worked with Peter on getting all the reference art for all the TARDISes through for every single Doctor. So I actually have an archive now of the right TARDISes for the right Doctors as reference art, because we were planning to do a new set of Doctor portraits, which would be primarily the art for their TARDIS, but with them standing in front. So you'd be able to take, you know, the 12th Doctor's TARDIS along with him specifically, or the 4th. And we start integrating, you know, more classic TARDISes. So it's on the list of things to do. We have all the references. It's just been season 8. We lost 3 months of production just doing all the cool season 8 stuff, which we love doing.
Well, it's not lost production. It's awesome production.
Like, we had a lot of stuff on the go, and that sort of stuff just we had to stop it, and we had to jump on season 8 to get as much of the new stuff in as possible while it was airing. We thought that would just be awesome.
Now that we have the casing, we need the bits which go inside it. We need some very carefully crafted gears and cogs, created with such mathematical precision that they are almost unequaled across the universe. Luckily, I know just the place. That's my Matt Smith impression.
The TARDIS materializes inside this marketplace on the Starship UK. Oh, it's Amy. Can you do an Amy impression for us?
I cannot even attempt an Amy impression. Sorry.
But, like, you've got, like, a Welsh accent, and she's, like, Scottish, so it's kind of ethnic, isn't it?
Yeah, it's sort of close, yeah.
It seems like so very long ago now, doesn't it, Doctor? Longer than you can ever imagine. Clickety-click, click-click-click. Doctor, a winder!
It's your farmer now. It's all creatures great and small.
That was Scottish. Scottish. Accent. Scottish accent. There was a really cool question that I was about to ask you, but someone seems to have overwritten it.
Oh, sucks. What was it?
I don't know. I can't remember. But if they do another question before I ask the first question, then the question disappears. Man. Maybe I can remember it if my brain turns back on. Oh, yes. I remember what it was, but I can't see who asked it now. It was Ken Williams. Ken Williams asked, have you ever considered making... No, Sam Bentley. Could you do a costume to design a new costume for any character after the gem competition? Because obviously Susan was talking before about the gem competition, which is coming tomorrow. Have you guys ever considered doing the same thing again, but, you know, perhaps someone else's artwork on an actual character?
I think that would be a lot, lot harder just because of the approvals process and trying to match the art of the game. I think that would be really, really, really hard. So no, we haven't really talked about that yet.
Okay, we'll get the gem ones out
of the way. There's some amazing gem designs got sent over. We're really excited about it. We're wrapping that up. Oh, did Susan talk about the new gems coming this week? We have new gems coming this weekend.
New Cybermen gems.
Yeah. Did she show them to you? I don't know if we keep it.
She didn't show us them.
No. Well, they're cool. We have some Cybermen gems for you to get all Cybermen-y about.
Someone's asking me if I'm going to show off the new Randall gems. If I get, probably not this week, because I think we're going to close up in about 5 minutes.
Oh, they're so beautiful. Oh, Addy, do it quickly. Yeah, beautiful things.
I'm in the middle of a level, man.
No, it's the end of the level. It's the end of the level. That's the combat. It's dialogue. Narrative.
I haven't fought anyone yet.
You did. It's for one round, but it's all expensive.
Hang on, this is Matt Smith speaking, and I can't remember. If he wants to help us, let us know. So, Simon, please take us to your engineering supply. Like, no, Simon's still fine. Oh, no, victory. Hooray! What did I fight?
A winder, who then joined your team. Somebody said, is there any timeline to get the 12th and the 4th in the game in the storyline? Yes, I would like to get it done by the 1 year anniversary of the game, which is in a few weeks. I'm pushing towards that. No guarantees, but I'm trying.
Oh, someone's asked for the 7th Doctor in a movie outfit. That would be quite
question,
cool.
Is there a possibility of a comic-style artwork for the relevant Doctors? Comic-style? We are talking to Titan.
Isn't the whole thing comic-style?
We're talking to Titan about doing possibly some Doctor outfits from their comic books as well. So yes. Maybe that could be another advent calendar thing. I think advent calendar is
a question. Why does the menu say setting, not settings?
Don't know. You're the first person to ever ask that.
Okay.
It's a good question.
Roundels.
Do you turn the roundels on?
I'm turning the roundels on. What was the new level this week for the... Oh, no. Was there a new level this week?
What did we release this week? I have to ask Susan. She gets things live. I just sit in the dark room designing things.
The one I've got at the top of my list is Mummy on the Orient Express.
No, that was older.
That must be from a few weeks ago.
Yeah, we were...
Oh, are they in the expert levels? Is that it?
Well, last week we were going to do Rusty, and he's pushed back a bit. Last week was the Brigadier Classic costume, wasn't it? Was added to one of the levels. Expert Brigadier was added. Ooh.
A time attack in the bubble universe. Okay, a bit of tension then to finish. Okay, if I'm doing a time attack, then you need to just do a solid announcements because I won't be able to do anything. Won't even be able to do any extended dialogue. Oh, hang on. No, time hasn't started yet. I can do this dialogue first.
We have the container, the gears. Now we need a paradox in the time vortex right outside the TARDIS's door, less than a click away.
We're being pulled into another pocket universe. That was my angry Sixth Doctor voice. The TARDIS lands with a bump on the top of a cliff overlooking an alien jungle planet. On a more positive note, the air hasn't instantly killed us. That's the TARDIS protecting us, extending a shield out and cleaning the air. Just look down there, thick jungle for miles. Suddenly, out of nowhere, it's the Crispy Master. What does the Crispy Master sound like? Trap with nowhere to run. I don't know what he sounds like. Oh, it's the other master. Many masters. Did you really think you could hide here in this pocket universe? Let's keep this quick, shall we? Make sure you don't suddenly get any ideas. It all happened so quickly. The two incarnations of the master started to press buttons on their paradox generators as a pair of Toclophane rushed at us. Good. Right. Annie versus Toclophane with gems. Exciting stuff. Right, Lee. Monologue. Go.
Let's watch you. I want to watch you. I get to watch you play.
Well, the time attack. Well, I've got to go. Oh, these are pretty. I like these. These are good. I do like these. It's very, very clear.
It is. It's very different. It took me some time to get used to playing with them. Yeah, I'm going to go through and I'm going to find some more questions. People keep typing questions in. Are you planning to do some other companions from the old series? Yes, we are planning to do as many as we possibly can from the old series. I don't want to give a list of like every character I would like to get in because it pretty much includes every character that we talked to. We will get to them one day. We will just keep adding and adding and adding, and who you love will get there.
Adding. No, just me. Okay. Never mind.
You should be concentrating on the game so you don't fail.
I'm trying to concentrate on the game, but when you set me up with jokes like that, man, I can't cope.
Have we ever thought about adding the Rani as one of the Master's allies? No. I would like to wrap up the Master storyline with just Masters. You know, I think all the different incarnations of the Master fighting all the incarnations of the Doctor would be cool. Would be cool. And have its own should have its own thing, its own storyline. And shouldn't be muddied up by adding, you know, the Rani, who feels like should be more of a Gallifrey focused classic storyline, perhaps. What squeaking going on?
The things that have happened to me are bad. God, I'm running out of time. My game's decided to go all laggy and... Oh, God, no.
Okay, I'll find some more questions. Did they ever realize that the randals are slightly larger when they get the non-transparent lock? You can see the color around it. Yes, actually. And the sidemen ones you can as well. I thought it was interesting to have that little thing in there. I didn't know how many people would notice. But yeah, we left it like that on purpose. But we reserve the right to change it. But I like it. It's slightly different. It makes it feel a bit different.
There we go. The game went very, very slow for a minute. But then victory popped up. Huzzah!
You won.
Time attack, Addy. Yes, I won. Good job, Addy. I earned 22,921 XP. Someone's described me as hosed. Aha. Well, who's got a wet face now, split level head? Yeah. Yeah. Do a little Addy dance. Wiggle the head. Wiggle the head.
What are you placing Cinder's artwork on? Could we possibly have... Oh, things keep scrolling up. The Engines of War level with the Scarrow delegation. We are working with George Mann, who wrote Engines of War, and an artist called Paul Hanley, and he's drawing Cinder. And hopefully George will be writing some text for the game where we will introduce Cinder and get her in the story, and possibly fighting the Daleks, yeah, for the book. We'll see. But yes, we are working with them, and we're really excited about getting the Engines of War stuff in.
I hope people will forgive me. But for next week's episode, or in fact, right for now, I've changed the Sahira.
Oh, it's Rusty. Sabre. Hi, Rusty. Oh,
with Rusty, because I think Rusty looks rather cool.
Rusty's awesome.
Rather cool. Right, I think this has been fun, but like all great things, it must come to the end. Whether it's the Roman Empire, whether it's Alexander the Great, whether it's the first season of Firefly, whether it's the DLC in Fallout. They must end, and so must this show. Any final thoughts or last-minute announcements or exclamations of love that you would like to give, Lee?
No, thank you to the community, I guess. You're all awesome. Keep being awesome. And we will talk to you next week. Enjoy the episode this weekend, and enjoy all the cool stuff that's coming for the game this weekend. If we don't mess it up and forget to push it live or something, we'll get out there. I don't know what the time frame is, but sometime this weekend. It'll be out with all levels and fun things, and you can curse at me when you play the hard levels, and when you fight giant spiders and you have an arachnophobia, you can just, you know, send me hate mail. But enjoy it all, and hang around. We got lots more stuff coming.
Woo! Obviously, I may or may not be around next week, but there will definitely be a Doctor Who Legacy show next Thursday. I will be here with Clary on Saturday night doing a review of the episode, and I've streamed at various other points as well. My Fallout 3 playthrough has continued on YouTube. I actually haven't been streaming them, but I have recorded 5 episodes this week, and they'll be coming out. So if you enjoy a bit of role play and with no stupid voices but just funsies, then do go head over and check that out. You can follow me on Twitch, of course. You can follow me on YouTube /TheAdipose TV, twitter.com/TheAdipose TV, and we've got a Facebook page as well if you're interested in joining the posse and being properly a part of our community and get yourself a little star by your name. Then do go and check out our website as well, theadipostv.com, and of course the Addy Meet is happening in February. If you want details, speak to the mods or ask after the chat. The chat is open all the time and there are always people in here chatting about Doctor Who Legacy or life or Doctor Who or occasionally licking, but it's a great place to hang out if you were friends. Lee, did you want to plug your shabazz?
Oh, follow us on Twitter and everywhere. We try to talk everywhere to everyone. Twitter, Facebook, the news page, the news. Oh, just Susan mentioned that the newsletter's going out early now. She does it on a Wednesday instead of a Thursday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it went out yesterday. We got it. We talked about it. It was
okay.
Good.
So yeah, if you want to keep up to date, the best way to keep up to date is probably the newsletter. Or just follow us on Twitter because we're constantly on those as well. But, you know, just tell your friends and keep playing the game.
Great. Thank you so much for joining us tonight, Lee. It's always a pleasure to have you and Susan on the show.
It's always amazing to be here.
And we will catch you guys next week. As normal, I'll play through adverts, and if you're still here after them, I will give you some bonus gold. And we will catch you all very, very soon. Goodbye.